The August 2020 Fusion 360 product update has introduced a highly anticipated command in the form of the Emboss feature. The defining aspect of the Emboss command is its ability to wrap closed profiles around non-planar faces to perform extrudes. Previously, this is something that could only be achieved via a workaround using the sheet metal feature. Let's start with a simple example. Here we have a sketch rectangle in front of a cylinder. We want to wrap this sketch around the cylinder and create an extrude from the resulting wrapped geometry. Make sure that the solid tab is active. Go to Create, Emboss. Select the rectangle as the profile. Take note that only closed profiles are accepted here. For faces, click on the select box and select the cylindrical face. Immediately, you can see a preview of the end result. For depth, you can change the value in the dimension field or drag the arrow. Dragging the arrow in the opposite direction beyond the cylindrical face produces a deboss or a recess. You can also switch between embossing or debossing by clicking on the effect options. With the alignment options, you can move the feature horizontally, vertically, or even rotate it. However, I would not encourage the use of these alignment options. Editing the sketch would be the preferable way. Let's remove the adjustments and just do a simple emboss. Let's analyze the end result. At the beginning of this video, I made the claim that this is a true wrap. Let's verify that claim. The length of the sketch rectangle is 100 mm. Go to Inspect, Measure, and select the inside edge of the extrude. You can see that it is exactly 100 mm. So this proves that the emboss feature really does wrap the sketch around the cylinder. You can also tell by looking at the front view with the sketch visible. The resultant extrude from this view is slightly narrower than the sketch, which is what you would expect from a wrap. Let's take a look at the nature of the extrude. If you look at the top view, we can see that the extrude radiates out from the center and is normal at all points to the cylindrical face. In other words, the top surface of the extrude is concentric with the cylinder. If we start a sketch on the top face and draw a circle from the cylinder center that is progressively larger, you can see that the circle matches up to the extruded surface. Keep this in mind for the later part of the video where we will be comparing this aspect to the other commands. Next, let's try using the emboss command with a text sketch. I suspect that this is what most users will be looking forward to trying with this new command. Here, we have a long string of random letters. Looking at the front view, the overall length exceeds the extent of the cylinder. This would really showcase the wrapping ability of the emboss command. Again, go to Create, Emboss. Select the text sketch as a profile. There is no need to explore the text sketch. Click on the select box or faces and select the cylindrical face. Make the necessary adjustments and click OK. The text has been wrapped around the cylinder with no distortion to the letters. As with the earlier example, the extrude radiates out from the center of the cylinder. So that was a quick summary of the emboss command. There are two other Fusion 360 commands that can produce somewhat similar features. How does the emboss command compare to them? Let's review the first opponent, the offset face command. We shall use the previous example with a sketch rectangle in front of the cylinder. Before we can perform the offset face command, we first need to split the face of the cylinder using the sketch. So right up front, the emboss feature already has an advantage as it does not require this step. Go to Modify, Split Face. Select the cylindrical face as the face to split. Click on the Select box for Splitting Tool and select the sketch. If we select Split with Surface as a split type, this produces a straight projection. If we click OK and look at the front and unhide the sketch, you can see that the split line exactly matches that of the sketch in this view. Let's go back into the split face feature. You also have the option of choosing a long vector, after which you will be prompted to choose a projection direction. If we select the Z axis, this produces the same effect as the split with surface option. There is also a third split type option in the form of closest point. Imagine drawing the shortest line from every point of the sketch rectangle to the face of the cylinder. This is essentially what you will get. This produces a distorted view of the sketch rectangle. The important point to take note here is that this is not a wrap. Let's revert back to split with surface and confirm the feature. Next, go to Modify, Offset Face. Select the split face and extend accordingly. Identical to the Emboss command, the extrude here radiates out from the center. The top face of the extrude is concentric to the cylindrical face. If we start a sketch on the top face and draw a circle from the cylinder center that is progressively larger, you can see that the circle matches up to the extruded surface. We can also use the same split face and offset face workflow using sketch text. However, for the case of text, we need to go in and explore the sketch before we can use that to split face. Since the split face command is limited to straight and closest point projections, this introduces distortions in the text. To sum up this matchup, the emboss command has the advantage over the offset face in that it does not require the face to be split beforehand. More importantly, the emboss command has the ability to wrap around non-planar faces, while the offset face command does not. Let's take a look at the next competitor, extruding from object. Go to Create, Extrude. Select the rectangle as the profile. For the start condition, select from object and select the cylindrical face. Adjust the extrude distance and confirm. Looking at the front view, the sketch exactly matches that of the extrude. Let's take a look at the top view. The extrude is in a direction normal to the sketch plane. If we look carefully at the resultant top surface of the extrude, it has the exact same curvature as the cylindrical face. In other words, these two faces are not concentric to each other. If we start a sketch on the top face and draw a circle from the cylinder center that is progressively larger, you can see that the circle does not match up with the extruded surface. The effect of this extrude is equivalent to taking a section of the cylinder here and translating it vertically up. This is the crucial difference to the emboss and offset face commands. Let's perform the same extrude operation using text. Since it is capable only of straight projections, you can see that the letters are severely distorted at either ends. To summarize this matchup, the extrude command can only do a straight projection and does not have the ability to wrap profiles. Also, the resultant surface retains the same curvature as the starting face. This is in contrast to the emboss and offset face commands, where the resultant face is concentric to the original face. After looking at what the emboss feature can do and how it stacks up against other similar features in Fusion 360, here's a simple flowchart to decide when and where to use each of these three features. First, we need to answer the question of whether we are doing planar or non-planar extrudes. For a planar extrude, you should always default to using the extrude command, as that gives you the maximum flexibility. For non-planar extrudes, if we need the feature to wrap around the non-planar face, use the emboss command. If we need a normal projection to the non-planar face instead of a wrap, the next question we need to ask is what is the nature of the resultant face of the extrude that is required? Do we need it to be concentric? Or do we need it to retain the same curvature as the starting face? If the answer is concentric, proceed to the split face and offset face workflow. If the answer is to retain curvature, proceed to extrude. In the next part of this video, we are going to take a look at some further aspects of the emboss command that you might be interested to know. Multiple closed profiles can be selected in a single emboss command. Besides smooth curved faces, the emboss feature can also be performed on angular adjoining faces. In this case, you will need to control select the faces. Let's take a look at the tangent chain option. So here we have a solid body with a planar face that is adjacent to a curved surface that is tangent to it. In front of the solid, we have a sketch rectangle that straddles across both faces. If the tangent chain option was checked while we selected faces, the two adjoining faces will be selected. If we uncheck the tangent chain option, we can select individual faces, and the emboss feature would only be created on the selected face. Some of you might face a potential problem when attempting to wrap geometry all the way around a cylinder. In this case, I have purposely made the overall length of the sketch longer than the circumference of the cylinder. Let's see what happens when we do the emboss. An error appears. This can also happen if a string of text is longer than the circumference. So you do have to measure the circumference and plan your sketch accordingly. On curved faces that are at an angle to the sketch, the emboss feature produces a twisting effect. Also, the emboss feature does seem to struggle on more complex faces. For example, this ring was created by revolving an arc. When I try to emboss this sketch rectangle, I am unable to select the face at all. Some final thoughts here. Although the emboss command is a great new feature, I do feel that Autodesk has missed a trick here by calling it emboss. The term emboss is a very general term for any feature that stands out in relief. By calling it emboss, users will not be aware of its core strength, which is its ability to wrap around non-planar faces. In fact, the word wrap does not exist at all in the tooltip. Furthermore, by calling it emboss, users might gravitate towards using this in all embossing situations without thinking about the nuances. This command might have been more appropriately named as the wrap command. My guess is that the Autodesk team wants to differentiate itself from SolidWorks, which does have a command named wrapped, which performs a similar function. I hope that this video has given you an adequate overview of the new emboss command and that you are better informed as to when and where to use this new command.